it's been pretty bad around here lately. Yesterday was a little better. Today's back a little worse. Can't see it. Too many of the local hills. Nobody in the river today. No deer jumping out in front of me. But yeah, you can see it's actually a little better, but well, it's cloudy. I mean, it's smoky. It's smoky. I'd love some rain. We might get some today. It could be enough. Clean the air up. Topaz Lake. Just had breakfast over at the lodge. I thought I would come down here and relax a little bit because it's so nice and cool. There's a light breeze. Ooh. There's a light breeze. There's a few people on the lake. And a lot of the smoke is gone. I'd say the majority of it, at least 80% of the smoke that we've had here is gone. Because we had a lot of rain last night from a huge thunderstorm. And I was hoping this is exactly what it would do. I was praying for rain because ever since I had my surgery on my sinuses 2 weeks ago, it wasn't but a couple days later, and all of a sudden the smoke hit from California fires. This is the third year in a row that my summers have been ruined by California smoke because they can't seem to control their forest fires. It won't be long before I have my boat on this lake. I finally got the registration on the trailer, so now I can get the engine checked out, and then I got a small patch to do on the bow, and we're gonna put it in the water here and have some fun. We're gonna camp out here and have the boat here and fish here, and this place is only about 35 minutes from my house. 40 minutes maybe, max. Yeah, it's probably half hour to 40 minutes. Not sure exactly, but close enough. And when there's no smoke, it's just beautiful here. So I love it. This thing's great. A Little Caesar. What year is it?
1956.
Well.
Might as well show them a picture here.
Yeah. Show us what's in the mailbox there. Oh, there you go. Howdy. Yeah.
You know, there were some five ladies went walking by one morning. And one of them opened up and she did just like that, you know, it spooked her, and all the other gals started laughing, you know, because you don't expect it. I never put it in there to scare anybody, though.
This is about the size of Wonder Hussy's trailer.
Yeah. You know, she doesn't give out directions no more. She used to.
Yeah, no, she
and
gave
us. Somebody had called her on giving a direction.
She quit doing it. Yeah. She tries to hide it, but for me, she always leaves some little telltale thing. And that's how I found the hot spring. So, but this is neat. Converted the dinette area so that half of it is all shelves and cupboards and stuff. And why not? It's just him. So only need that one little part of the table. But yeah, you can tell it's been around. Been around, to say the least. Gotten good use out of it. And other than this front section here, it's all original. So, yeah. That's neat. That's a lot of seasoning. He's got way more seasoning than I do. How cool. Yeah, I was just, like I say, I was bringing the dog down to, you know, because we come down here and I like to go and walk her down. There's a little trail where that guy's camped. Mm-hmm. Goes along the river, way back up that way. So I take her up there and she pokes into the river and, you know, stuff like that. But yeah, those people, God, I don't want to. Are they gone now? No, they're still there.
I pulled in here through the years. There's never ever been anybody here except in 1973. Well, I was working at USG up there at Empire out of Gerlach.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Lab tech up there. And I quit. I gave him 2 weeks' notice, but then Sanders wanted me to stick around. And
yeah, sure enough they did. Well, that's a neat little camper.
I love it.
Yeah.
I've always. Oh.
I gave him a lens for this guy here, so I just happened to have an extra one, so I gave him that. But yeah, if you go on my website, you can see how to, you know, repair all this stuff. It's pretty easy. What happens here is, you see this little tab here?
Yeah.
You bend that up and you disconnect the hardware in there, and the whole thing just slides out this way.
Huh.
And then you can replace the gaskets that's supposed to be in here. You know, replace, you'd have to replace the glass because
yeah,
you're not going to get that silicone off very easy.
I will replace it.
But inside there's little screws and nuts all the way around on a retainer clip that holds the glass in.
Oh, okay.
And like I say, these are called pushouts, hair pushouts. HEHR is the name of the company that makes them.
Huh.
And I've got videos on how to completely restore these things. So, you know, something you could do in your spare time if you wanted to, one window
well,
at a time. See, this one's folded up already, so somebody's probably had this one out. But this is the glass seal that you you put new rubber in here like this.
Uh-huh.
It's nice, soft, gray stuff. And that seals keeps the water from getting in there. And a lot of times you have to remove this drip cap in order to get this thing out. See, you'll probably hit this thing and won't be able to get it out any further. But that's the way you fold the tab up to do it. So you remove the drip cap, fold the tab up, pull the window out, and you can replace everything. You just have to undo this screw here for each one of these pieces of hardware for these latches.
Okay.
And then the whole thing slides out. And you can replace the screen on this window if you ever decide you want to do that, you know.
That screen is
so
original.
Oh yeah, I can tell.
Yeah.
A lot of people have holes in their screens because they've run TV wire in there and stuff.
I've always been happy with this ever since I bought it. And I've had other stuff, including a Desert Fox toy hauler in my last marriage. I didn't buy it because the toy I was going to do buying and selling, you know, go
yeah,
around and buy stuff and sell out of it and set it myself up different places. But then that divorce came up, so I had to get rid of it.
Well, that happens.
Yeah.
Somebody rebuilt this window and they replaced both of these.
That was me.
Okay, yeah, with this type of thing here instead.
That's a friend of mine
yeah,
in Caliani had a friend that was an RV guy.
Mm-hmm.
And then he got these windows for me, so I
put those in. Okay, and this one is easy enough to replace. I have a video on that too.
I always thought that had a nice personality.
Yeah, it does. But if you ever wanted to replace it, you don't want to hurt these clips. These are hollow retainer clips, and you got to dig into the corner right down there to get it started, and it pops out this way, and you release them all. There'll be two in the two side ones go in last when you're putting it back in. The upper and the bottom one go in first. So you would take the side ones out first, then the top and the bottom.
Okay.
And this glass comes out. And then you can put a new piece of glass in there and put the clips back in, and that's all there is to it.
Someday. You know, I'd never.
Well, again, you just go to my website. It shows how to do all that.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, got you right here. Saying goodbye to Sonny. He's visiting us here. And I saw his trailer and I had to stop by and talk to him and see about his crew. So, Sonny, thanks for all the info. You have yourself a good one. We'll talk to you later. See ya. All right, that was Sonny. As Little Caesar. Great little trailer. Pretty much original, except for the front area where he made all that cabinet work I showed you and stuff. Cool guy. 78 years old. And he's just traveling around all over the place. Retired from the railroad in Alaska. years and years ago. Been traveling with that little camper ever since. So isn't that something? And I ran into him right here at our rest stop near where I live. So I gave him a beehive lens to replace the broken one that he had on his trailer. Gave him some magnets and stickers and stuff. And yeah, maybe we'll see Sonny again. Who knows? That was fun. Nice way to spend a Sunday afternoon. Okay, if I sound like I'm out of breath, it's because I am. This was not easy. That's a heavy coil of metal. That's the roof for the 48 main line. And we went up through pulleys attached to the roof. And then you can see we got the lines coming down like here. I put an eye hook in the wall because we have to be able to move the trailer under it now. We couldn't have these lines that are coming down in our way. And this one goes down to an eye hook in the wall over here. And so now we're going to push the trailer underneath and then gently lower the roof down, the roof coil down on top and unroll it. We're taking a break. That was fun. Was that fun?
I love it. That was fun. If it was easy, anybody could do it.
You got that right. Well, I thought the camera was on when we lowered the roof down and then unrolled it, but it wasn't. One of the things I don't like about the new cameras, my old camera used to beep if it turned off. And my GoPro beeps if it turns off, but this camera and my big camera don't. So it's one of the things I don't like about them. So if they turn off because they run out of, you know, room in the card or the battery's dying or whatever, they don't tell you. Anyway, all we did was lower it down from up there and then, you know, untape it. We just cut the tape with knives, and then it wants to do the Three Stooges thing. It wants to uncoil by itself, but we do it in a controlled fashion. And it's real simple. It's not hard at all. So anyway, the roof is on it, laying up there. Now, what the tape is for is to help relieve the coil. Spring in the coil, you know, in other words, it wants to coil back up. And we want to undo that, relax it. We're relaxing the metal. So for a few days, it stays like this. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to put some eye bolts in the floor with anchors that I can unscrew so it'll be flat again. I can walk without tripping on them later. And come on, focus. And we will be grabbing a hold of the metal. You'll see all this. Be grabbing a hold of the metal with some wood and some bolts and stuff. You'll see how it works. Pulling it down tight. And we'll do the same thing in the front. We will pull the front down tight. And when we do all that, then we will go ahead and scribe our windows, the cutouts for our windows. And we'll also be able to mark for the width so we can cut trim this metal down, and then we'll be able to install it by putting the corner cap rail on in the middle. It'll go from about halfway through each curve all the way over to the other curve. They're 16 feet long, so that's where it'll all start, and we'll clamp that down, get it all installed, and then we can move our way forward and rearward to finish it off. It'll involve cutting metal and pulling it tight and fastening it and all that kind of stuff. But right now we're just letting it relax so it'll be easier to deal with. But it'll look great. Oh, this trailer's looking so good. Well, I guess that's about it for now. Make sure and join us next time when we go ahead and fasten down the roof. I'll show you some of the cutting that we do and how we tighten the metal all up. And all that good stuff, all the stuff you want to see. So we'll see you next time. This is Larry, Mobile Tech, with CanhamTrailers.com. Remember, I make mistakes so you don't have to. See you next time, folks. What are you grunting about? Yeah, you. I'm making all that noise when I'm trying to make a video here. Huh? What's up with that?
Yeah. What do you care?